Well, howdy, howdy, howdy. I am glad to be here. Hope you are too. I have gotten a lot of comments and emails on how to get started. People that are broke. And it doesn't mean you're poor. It just means you're broke. And I've been broke many times in my life. And so I sympathize completely. And a lot of people go, well, you can't. Some people are negative to me and go, you can't even do this without money. You can't do this. And I can prove them wrong. And there's literally thousands of vendors that can prove them wrong. You can do this on a shoestring budget. You can start with just stuff in your house and make this work. It just depends on your motivation. And like I said before, it doesn't mean you're going to go into this business and this is going to be your new career and you've always dreamed since you were a little kid in kindergarten wanting to be a hot dog vendor. No, this may just be a step that gets you to wherever you want to be. Maybe it provides the freedom and the finances so that you can now do whatever you want to do. And that's the beauty of it. So what I want to share is that I did a blog article at learnhotdogs.com. And if you look right down here, you'll see it, learnhotdogs.com/broke. And that broke part will take you right to the part about starting with little to no money. And I mean it, little money or no money, there's a way to start. And I'll show you how some others have done it, and I'll show you how the best ways. And I'm going to pull that up real quick so that you can see it. But this is the page you'll see when you get here. And this is a real picture. I'm superimposed in front of it, but the picture in the background is a real picture from a vendor who started with nothing, started with scratch, and started vending. Couldn't afford a cart. And started vending like this with a table. Then he eventually afforded a tent, and he got bigger and bigger. And his story's in this article as well. But I've got quick tips on finding a cart, finding a used cart, looking for deals. This is the time of year that you can find used carts. A lot of people get into the business and then go, you mean I got to actually do something? And then they sell their cart on Craigslist and Facebook. So I created a platform on Facebook so that people could just sell their carts. It doesn't cost anything. I don't make a dime on it. We just manage it so that people aren't running scams through it. And so there's all kinds of ways to find good deals, and I teach you that here. Now, if you look, there's the slow cooker method, and you'll read about two different people that we had that started with a slow cooker. There's been more since then, but they just started with a slow cooker and a table. Then there's crowdfunding. My least favorite way to do it, but if you do it right, you can win with it. We had a vendor do it right and really won with it. Had enough money to buy a full-fledged food trailer because of crowdfunding. And so they're like a GoFundMe page, but a lot of people even get lazy with that and don't do what I say. I have a GoFundMe tutorial that's free here at learnhotdogs.com. You can go on there and see exactly what to do the right way so that you get the biggest amount of people wanting to help your cause instead of just going, hey, I've had a bad life and I need a hot dog cart. Please help me and donate. People are overwhelmed with stuff to donate to. And so you don't want to overwhelm them. You want to be an interesting story. You want to be something they are proud. They go, man, he put a lot of effort into this. I'm willing to put $20 into it to help him, or $200 or whatever it is. So I teach you that. The cottage industry, this is all free, by the way. There's nothing for sale here. You just go take it. A lot of people go, a lot of people's mindsets are that they, and I'm not saying you, but a lot of people will say, man, if it's free, it ain't worth the crap. I ain't getting it. And then if it's for sale, they go, why is he selling? They should give this stuff away if he's really wanting to help. So I do both. Check that out. I'm a people pleaser. So what I do is I put it all out for free. And then if I have some really awesome content and I get a lot of questions about a certain thing, I'll go, you know what? I'm going to make a course out of the free content. And then I sell a course. But you ain't got to buy a course. You can just go get it for free. So however you want to do it, you can. So I feel morally obligated to share it. So that's what I do. The magic button, some of you enjoy and get a kick out of that. So I give you the slow cooker option. I even give you some pictures of it. I give you how they started and what they ended up with. I give you the stuff about the breakdown on the crowdfunding, the cottage industry. This is my most favorite way to do this business. As far as if you have limited funds, can't afford a cart, or your state says, nope, got to have a cart, or you can't do it. Well, see that in writing first. Okay, don't ever take their word for it. Go to learnhotdogs.com/liar, and you'll see why you need to ask. Because a lot of health inspectors go, no, you can't do it without a cart. You can't have hot dogs without a cart. Bull crap. Most states, that isn't the case. It's just a couple out there that do have a rule that you have to be in an enclosed or be working a piece of machinery of some sort. I don't know. I think you'll like that and you'll appreciate that. So, cottage industry. You can't afford a cart, let's say. Or don't want to take money that you have that is in reserve to gamble on something maybe that you don't like or that you're unsure of, or your spouse says, no way, Jose. And so what you do is you use the cottage industry. So we have thousands, and when I say thousands, literally thousands of vendors that I have been so fortunate to be able to help start with cottage food and then grow into whatever they want. Some stayed in cottage food and are making a killing. But some people go, you know, I like cottage food, but now I can go buy a cart or a trailer or a food truck or whatever I want to do. We've had some open a restaurant right after cottage food. So lots of ways to do this the right way. Cottage food is my most favorite because all 50 states allow it, and you can do it today. So you can take, you can go, Ben, I don't have a dime. I can't spend a dime on nothing. You can go to, I'm going to give you the website. Well, the link's here too, but you can go to cottagefoodlaws.com, and you can go in there, look for your state, and just open it up, and that's what you're required to do. Most states don't require hardly anything. So you can start with no money and you can go, well, I got flour and butter and milk. I'm going to make muffins or I'm going to make cornbread and I'm going to sell my mamaw's cornbread and make money. And I show you how to sell it so that you can make money, how to make it appealing to make money. And you can go grab all this stuff and go and start tonight. Well, the biggest thing I want to put in your head though, and I'm not done with this page, so stick with me. The biggest thing I want you to understand is when you feel like there's no light at the end of the tunnel or that the light that's there is a freaking train coming at you because of the overwhelming odds and the overwhelming things that are going on in our lives and going on in an economy and going on with the world, and you go, I just feel like I can't do nothing. I'm working down here at such and such, and I'm barely getting by, and we've had to borrow money from the church or borrow money from family just to make ends meet. I have been there, done that, and millions of people are doing that today. But maybe you today see this and go, you know what? I'm going to change that crap. I'm going to change that. I'm going to make an effort to spend 2 days a month on my cottage food business. And I'm going to go to cottagefoodlaws.com and I'm going to look up my state there because it's all there for you. And you just go, okay, I'm going to do this. I'm going to make chocolate chip cookies. I'm going to be the chocolate chip cookie king of Chicago. And you just make whatever you want to do. We had Diana's Bloom Cakes do it. We've had so many people do this business, and you can see them all on my Facebook, or I don't have a Twitter and Instagram, but I did start a TikTok. So you can go over to TikTok, and I'll put the link down below. But I want to encourage you to go. You can do something. That there actually is an answer. And it may not be what you thought, and it may not be what you want permanently, but it may be enough to give you some breathing room. So all of a sudden, you're not worried about next week's electric bill or the rent come due Tuesday or any of that, because now you've got this side income coming in that doesn't require a lot of your time. It's not like taking a second job. So you get to control the hours. You become your own boss. You become the leader of your pack. And that's what it's about. That's the when you get to sleep at night. So let me finish this. So cottage industry is where I stopped. And that is the best thing since sliced bread and peanut butter and honey and jam. So it's just the best. And I would encourage you to go there. You can go to kitcheninincome.com and look at the ways people are doing it. People are selling spices and jars out of their kitchen. Okay, they're buying them in bulk, bottling them up, and going, this is Bob's best spices. And they're selling them legally, and you can do it too. And you don't have to go through the FDA and the US Ag. A lot of this you don't have to go through. You can go through your state ag and start doing it. And it's so easy. shoestring budget carts. I talk about those, and one of them is building your own cart. So I couldn't build a cart if you paid me, okay, without what I'm fixing to tell you. So I have a partner. His name's Keith, and I talk about him a lot, and you get to see him in some of the videos. And he is an engineer, and so he has a brain and a half. He's like MacGyver. He can make stuff happen with building and doing stuff. So he created a video series of how to build a cart, and he did it multiple different ways. So if that's something you're interested in, you can go to buildacart.com and build a cart. It's winter. You know your butts ain't going outside in the winter because it's too freaking cold. So you can build a cart in your garage and be making money soon. There's so many ways to make this happen for you. Let me share some others. So I got faster, cheaper, better. This is a tabletop brand, our tabletop system of burners that works great. It's what the first picture I showed you at the top. Remember this picture right up here? That's what they're using. They're using them little tabletop burners. And there's different variations of them, but you can start this cheap as dirt. If you wanted to set it up on a table and start doing funnel cakes or start doing fried nuts or start doing roasted nuts or start doing whatever you want to start. Excuse me. So you can do all this. This person here, over 800 hot dogs without a cart with that set up. They did 800 hot dogs in a day without a cart. So are they a hot dog vendor? Abso-freaking-lutely. And they did it all there. So they did it all without a cart. Anyway, I give you links to all the stuff. So the portable stoves, and sometimes Amazon changes these links. So just look up the keywords if you want. But I give you links to steam pans and everything else that you could possibly want. This person started with a crock pot. The next week, that is the actual cart she was able to buy. She was on a dirt road. Do you see the dirt road she's on? She was on a freaking dirt road with them little card tables with a sheet over it and two crock pots and one extension cord. And she was able to vend. In her state, it was legal to do it that way. I teach you how to find out all that stuff and how to go through this. Some of you won't have any problem at all finding that information. Some people may get to their health department and go, oh, we can't do a crock pot, Ben. They said no. Ask for it in writing. That's why I mentioned learnhotdogs.com/liar. So look that up first. Always check what they tell you. Because typically, if their lips are moving, they're lying. And I don't mean that in a bad way, really, because I just say it facetiously. That most of the time, they just don't want to deal with it, so they just make up something. Or that they make up something that sounds good, and usually it ain't true. So sometimes they don't do it intentionally, you know, like they're trying to keep you out of business. They just don't know, so they just give you something because they're supposed to know. And so this is a single mom. You can watch that interview here that started with a crock pot, and that's her setup there. You can see that whole video. Look at that. Simple system. So this is just one way. Me right now today, okay, if you'd asked me this 5 years ago, this question, Ben, what would you do if you didn't have anything to beg, borrow, steal, and plunder to be able to get a hot dog cart? What would you do? I would have said 5 years ago, do what I'm showing you right now. Go get a table, put the burners up, put a crock pot up, do your stuff that way. Get your licensing, right? But now, today, I'd go, you know what's daunting to some people to go get a license, because some health departments go, well, you need to have some commercial equipment, or you need to, you know, it can't be just a crock pot. Well, I need to see that in writing, Mr. Health Inspector, before you tell me I can't do it. And they ain't going to be able to approve that, so you can still go with it. But it seems daunting to have that discussion. Today, I would tell people to go to Cottage Food. So go to cottagefoodlaws.com, and if you want to see stories of other people and more information about it, kitcheninincome.com, you can go to this and go grab that information and go, okay, this is how I'm going to start. This is how Ben would start today. If I lost everything today, you can bet your bottom dollar I'd be in some kind of HUD housing somewhere if I lost everything, and I would be with a stove, and I'd be making something that is legal to sell in my state, that's backed by the Department of Agriculture in my state, and I would be making money, period. And a couple weeks later, I'll guarantee you I'll be buying a cart, or I'll be buying a different setup, or I'll be expanding my kitchen income, my cottage food, you know, business. I will keep going. So anyway, that's all the stuff there. I do want to remind you, we are giving away two carts this month. In fact, it's like, I think 14 days away. If you don't know anything about it, you're just hearing about it, and you're going, oh my gosh, and it's still before the end of November 2022, when you see this, then you are going to want to go over to learnhotdogs.com, and a little box pop up, and you can get on my email list, okay? You can get off of it anytime you want. There's no fee for it. It's just an email list, okay? And you can be on that email list and go, okay, now I can do, I'll keep you updated, is the bottom line, on the email list. So I'll keep you updated. And then after the giveaway, if you don't want to get emails from me, just go hit the unsubscribe at the bottom of it. I'll cry a little bit, but I'll make it. Okay. So then, if you want another way to do it, join Vendors United. That link, I'm gonna take this off the screen real quick. So that link is, I think, right here. Yeah. So vendorsunited.com, if you want to join that, it's free to join. It gives you a full trial. So you can go in and you can take all the courses and everything and get all the freebies if you want. I don't care. And go in there and learn from other vendors and leave. Or you can go, you know what? This is a small investment to make my life and my business better. And then you do that. And then you make your life and your business better. And you become whatever you want to become. Okay, unless it's like a leprechaun or something. You can't do that. So the bottom line is, if you will do one of those two things, you'll get the updates. And you'll be able to see when the date and time. I think it's the 28th at 9 p.m. It's a Monday. Okay, it's the last Monday of this month. There you go. So you can pull out your fancy calculator calendar thing and figure that up. All right. So I will be back soon. Thanks for all the comments. I opened it today. I was like, oh my gosh, I'm never going to get to all these. So I killed a bunch of birds with one stone just now, because a lot of the stuff that I get is about making money with no money. How do I get started, Ben? I can't afford a cart. And I understand that. Been there. So I'm going to show you, and I have today, how to do that. I love you. Talk to you soon. Bye.